Welcome to Gord Field in Detroit Rock, Michigan. Nice town, isn't it, Bricks?
Well, by nice, you mean a town that would welcome you by cold cocking in the head with a vacuum cleaner and stealing your luggage in the middle of a motel check-in and throwing you off the bridge into a polluted lake? Well, enjoying your morning walk to the stadium? Then yes, Grim, very nice town. Couldn't be lovelier.
The teams are juiced up and ready for blood as they take the field for MFL action. The Grim Bay Attackers battle the Motor City Maniacs. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
I'm a skill on Shiloh. I am a hell of a fellow.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast. I'm the greatest, I tell you.
The paddy wagons in the parking lots are full. The familiar scent of bodily fluids in the air, and the men's room is both flooding and on fire. And that means MFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzer along with Bricks and Bricks Jr.
Man, last week some mute let out a lava blast in one of the stalls in the men's room. Place went up like an oil rig. Flames and explosions, water shooting out of where the toilets were. I electrocuted myself using the electric hair dryer. I wish they had paper towels at least as an option.
And the running game is starting to click now. A pickup of 8 on the play. Second down and 2.
You can't keep a good mutant down.
I've seen this guy run through a brick wall.
You knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. And it's 1st and 10. And that's some good old-fashioned downhill running as he picks up 9 yards on the play. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. And that's the way you play a guy. Nice coverage. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. And a hard run there picks up the 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. And catch for 3. The receiver needs to break some tackles. Second down and 7. Interception! And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. Second down and more than the QB would like. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
Ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. second down and 10. Second down, the defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. First down and 3. Second down and 6. At this point, with multiple interceptions, with the brutal hit. Dirty trick, negating that play completely. The offense is pissed.
Well, I wish I had that trick in the elevator with me earlier. I let one rip. I made a really good one, Grim. And then the doors open and the team's cheerleaders get on. That's what small talk is really put to the test.
Yo, seriously, man, you think you'd go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor. Anyone said never hit a man when he's down? It's just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
And it's first and 10. Pickup of about 3 on that play. Second down and 7. Nicely done for a first down. First and 10. Oh, he just got crushed. Second down and 5. First down. And the running game opens up for them and allows the... come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. First down and 5. just went down.
Hey, I almost got Dead Mutant Bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
Second down and 7. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. Third down and 6. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's 1st and 10. And the defense gets the quarterback for a sack.
Nobody can touch me when I ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about?
Second down and a lot. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. First and 10. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him. Ah, going in circles.
It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
And it's 1st and 10. That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Second and 3. Nice and easy, like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. First and 10. And they stack the line, and he gets his bell rung for a yard. Second down and 9. To dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, you know, mostly coffee. Tastes better, like Eskimos burying salmon heads, kimchi. Fermented anything really tastes good.
And the quarterback throws another pick. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And it's first and 10. A vicious kill.
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schwong Galaxy phone.
Second down and 10. And another interception. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots. Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot! Yeah. That's why we love the MFL! Second down and inch. Defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. And it's first and 10. If you don't hear it coming, it'll knock you right on your head. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. First down and 3. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and 10. You know, a lot of guys talk about stepping up their game, Bricks. He just stepped up and the offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
First and 10. And the QB might as well just bury himself now. I hope you covered your ears, Bricks. He's off to the races. Look at that little... Oh, man, Bricks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting. First and 10. Oh, he's going berserk. The ball carrier better watch out. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big peregrine. You're right.
And it's first and 10. The dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much. much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass.
Yeah, well, at least they don't have to forfeit them.
That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. Defender's eyes, netting him a pickup of about 8 on the play. Second down and 2. First and 10. The defender says, I don't think so. Second down and 10. And he breaks away. He blasts it and picks up 7 yards right there. Takes a timeout here. They have 2 left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just gonna take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
Man, this guy just exploded into flames. Now the defense has to try to tackle a running bonfire. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. No need for a funeral. He was just cremated on the field. Suck it up and hopefully not die. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and 10. Say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And it's first and 10. And this guy is making a name for himself tonight with a pickup of about 10 on that play.
He makes up a name for himself.
The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
And the quarterback drills one in for the first down.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last 3 plays. Talk about luck!
And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. And with another pick, the QB says...
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And it's first and ten. Oh, he just got crushed! Second down and five.
Say what? Come on, man. You can't hang with me. You get my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. You understand me?
And that'll bring up third down and seven. It's a tie game at the end of quarter two. The teams are deadlocked in a fierce struggle today. We'll be right back with today's halftime show brought to you by Monsatan Industries. Eat their delicious Frankenfood.
Hey, throw in the half. Can you pick me up a Soylent beer?
The teams come out of halftime all tied up and ready to battle it out.
Oh, geez, Grim. I hope someone unties them soon. They gotta play football.
Nobody can touch you with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. Nothing out of it. Second down and ten. And the QB might as well just bury himself now because this guy's full on berserk.
Well, at least he could set himself on fire.
Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. First and ten. Wow! The quarterback just threw a sonic blast to his receiver, knocking down the antenna. He snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. First and ten. And he was stuck to him like glue. Second down and ten. First down. He was, and that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. First down and six. He's not just burning down the house, he's taking it to the house. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. The offense has no running back left, so this becomes a passing only offense. Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights! The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. destruction in his path. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep.
The kicker died on that play.
That's terrible. Now what do they do?
Well, another player will assume the kicking role for the remainder of the game. The coach is praying he won't need a long field goal to win this one. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
You know, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and ten. Killer, it was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league. Yeah.
Second down and 10. Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Bricks. Very smart.
Sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a
oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
And it's first and 10. It's 2 yard run before he stopped. You knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. Oh, great catch! And that's a touchdown! Touchdown! Well, that's a strange penalty call right there.
Making a lot of dollars.
Second down and long. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down in a mile. And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Sleeties this morning. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham and sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. It's a time warp dirty trick. The last play is erased. How did they do that?
Did they go 88 miles per hour? Just asking.
And he just slipped. And that is a big gain. You know the defense wants some payback after that. Third down and never gonna happen. And he's off to the races. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Oh, mama, he just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
It's first and ten. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jet, you son of a bitch.
Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
First and ten. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. The ref calls a penalty. You know, the MFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
Stupid jerks. You guys suck.
First and four. And that'll be second and eight to go. And the defense gets another.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
First and ten. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor. Finish him.
And it's first and ten. That one's incomplete. Receiver couldn't get there.
And yeah, neither could his mother.
Second down and ten. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and ten. With that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's gonna kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him. Ah, I'm going in circles!
And it's first and ten. Another pick. Man, this quarterback must have learned a lot about oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And it's first and ten. It's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72.
And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. And it's first and ten. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. Come on. little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and ten. Second down in a very lot. And oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and ten. First down and five. Oh man, what a great throw! Great catch! And that puts 6 points on the board!
The defense couldn't do anything to stop a throw that good, Ben!
You mean aside from priming the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and ten. Oh, the receiver has to make that catch. Now he put the team in a hole. Second down and ten.
Ah, another interception.
Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? First and ten.
Oh my gosh! The defensive player looks like he's lost his mind! Oh man, he really wants it! Oh sure, now he catches it! I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
For a touchdown. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What? And kick the kicker's job in half? They just.
It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grin?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
Boom! ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got Dead Mutant Bingo. All I need is 77 to fight him.
The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And it's first and 10. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. First and 4. Deflated the quarterback's balls right there. Second down and 9. That's a 6-yard gain on that catch. Down and 3. And with another pick, the QB says, I don't always throw interceptions, but when I do, it's when the game is... Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
First and 10. Oh, with a punishing hit. Second down and 5. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Third down and 5. And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick 6. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. And he's got a chance for a good return here. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
And it's first and 10. For the first down. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. Second down and 10. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completions. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right. I do do it.
First and 10. didn't see it. At least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts so you can use them in the two-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
Second and three. First down. Looks like they're just gonna pound it up the middle all night, Bricks.
They call that the honeymoon.
They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
And it's first and 10. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Of course, hold everything. Looks like there's a penalty on the play. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. And there's a huge gain, and this offense is rolling.
Mom, Grim, that was a pass play. Rolling plays are in.
And that's the last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore.
Can any of us really stop the clock, Grim? I mean, when it comes right down to it, are we not all united by the constant reminder of our own mortality? Of death's constant, relentless advance? If only it was as easy as.
He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked. The offense is down to their final receiver. They'll be playing shorthanded for the rest of the game.
And if they lose him, will they have to forfeit? Talk about pressure. I'm going to have to take the value before this one ends.
Hey, y'all been out on me.
First and 10.
He could go all the way.
Went back to the bench. He dropped it, you putz.
Second down and 10. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Third down and 9. The Maniacs deliver a bloody win for the Motor City. The entire game was trench warfare. Both teams battling back and forth, bruised and battered, but in the end, there could be only one winner.
There are winners in my book. I think that a defeated team should get a participation award because I tried really hard.
Why don't you try real hard and shut the fuck up?
Nice mouth. Why don't you try to lay off the scotch, Junior?
Suck on it.
Real nice. Let's go to the game's MVP. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...